old were you when you flew at Okinawa?
Talk louder so we can...
You have to put that almost on your lips to talk. Go ahead.
I don't know.
You don't know how old you were? You'd be pretty
You're about 4 or 5, I think.
4 or 5. We're going to taxi down to the threshold of 1-5.
Cleburne Regional Airport.
Automated weather observation, 1-5-1-0, Zulu. Wind, 1-9-0, at 1-3 knots. Peak gusts, 2-1 knots. Visibility, more than 1-0.
Today, we don't have any weather issues, really. It's the only thing important is the wind. We'll have a right crosswind, but it's not anything dangerous or bad.
Right now, you're steering with your feet, right?
Yeah. Like, I used to have a problem when I first started taking training. I was doing this, and my instructor would hit my hand. He'd say, put your arm out the window. It's like a tractor. Can you touch it? Yeah. Push real hard. Just push as hard as you can. Okay, you just make it, made us make a left turn, push to the right. So anyway, stay out of those pedals. Okay, I'm going to park right down here, and I have to do some things on a checklist. This is the attitude indicator. It tells me two things. It tells turn and bank, and it tells climb and descend. Very important instrument if you ever get in clouds. Fly this instrument more than anything. This is called flaps, and if you'll see the flaps lowering, this has giant flaps. It's got like 40 degrees. It's like a barn door, and you use them when you're landing to get really slow.
Yeah.
Those are called flaps. Now they're back up.
Are those hydraulic?
No, they're electric.
Okay.
They're electric flaps, yeah. I don't have anything hydraulic except my brake.
You have to check your mixture and stuff like that too?
Well,
then,
I can, yeah,
automatic?
The mixture, I keep it pretty rich. Mixture is right here. It's this orange knob here. And I can make it really rich. That means mostly gas and a little bit of air. It's really rich on gas. But I can pull it back and kind of take the gasoline out of that mixture that's going into the cylinders. And it's mostly air. But I usually adjust that, and I usually keep it pretty rich on the ground, and when I get to altitude, I'll try to even out the fuel and the air mixture on this knob. Fuel selector, we have two tanks, but I usually fly off both. It's gravity fed. There's tanks in the right wing, the left wing, and it's gravity fed. And I use both tanks to feed into the engine up here. I can run on one engine or one tank or the other tank, but you always want to use both. I do three things on the runway. I start my flight timer. I put my directional indicator on the runway heading. It should be 1-5. And be sure my transponder's set.
Approaching runway 1-5.
I'm going to taxi up. This is called the hold short line. When you cross it, you're on an active runway. You better be paying attention. Always check final. Don't have to have a radio, so I always look to see if an airplane screaming down final that hadn't announced on the radio. I don't see anything there. Cleburne traffic, Skyhawk 1802 Victor, taking the active 1-5, departing to the south, Cleburne.
Entered runway 1-5, 5,600 feet remaining.
Skyhawk 02 Victor on the go off 1-5 southbound heading Cleburne. There's the high school.
Yeah, there's the hospital.
Yep. There's Smith Middle School.
I see Smith.
Yeah. I'm going to make a right turn and come back over Smith Middle School. We'll go up towards downtown.
There's my school.
Yeah, Smith.
I can see our shadow down there. Do you see it, Matthew?
There's Gerard.
Yeah, I see it.
When you have a high-wing airplane and you turn, you can't see.
Yeah.
Unless you're in a C-130 where the wing is behind you.
hot far are we?
Well, it's a good question. We're at 2,500. This little clock right here tells me.
Right there, I see it.
You see your house?
Yep. See it, Dad? There.
Yes.
There's Uncle Don's house.
Now I can see her shadow again if you look straight down, Matthew.
That's good.
A lot of swimming pools.
A lot of people have more pools than you think out there. We'll go over Fort's building where your dad works, and we'll go by the swimming pool.
Hey, there is a lot of swimming pools.
Yeah.
There's flashlight.
Yeah, we'll go over it. I was going to go over your dad's work building right there, the Quinn Court building.
I see it.
South Nolan River Road, right there. Should be a fire station. The green roof, there it is.
I see it.
The Uncle Don's house?
I'm looking for it.
I see it.
Yeah, I think so, right there.
Catamount traffic, jump line 96 Delta, jumpers away. We got jumpers in the air over Catamount.
That would be fun, too. I've always wanted to do that.
Yeah, that doesn't interest me as much. That kind of scares me. I want to have a set of wings.
I would agree with you on that.
Dad, you see that lake right underneath the bus?
Yes.
Me and Grayson went fishing there.
Cool.
Cleburne traffic, Skyhawk 02 Victor, entering a right downwind for 15, full stop, Cleburne.
So if we talk while you're on the radio, will we go out too?
Well, if I'm pushing transmit, I have this little red button right here.
I didn't know if we were tied into that or
no,
if it was separate.
No, not at all. Cleburne traffic, Skyhawk 02 Victor, right base, 15, full stop, Cleburne. Cleburne traffic, Skyhawk 02 Victor, final for 15, full stop, Cleburne.
1 mile, final runway 15.
Let's check the wind.
Wind 170 at 17 knots.
Ah, we banged. That wasn't a good landing there. Sorry about that.
That's okay.
That was fun.
I was a little too slow and I was too high, so I dropped. Cleburne traffic, Skyhawk 02 Victor, clear of the active on golf, Cleburne. Okay, we had fun today.
I sure did.
It was a lot of
fun.
Yeah,
I love flying.